Whatever treatment we'll be talking about, it is all about the primary teeth and the young permanent teeth. So be careful, DPC is done in young permanent tooth, but it is only not done in primary teeth. Okay? There is a history of pulse therapy given in your keynote. So these are just dates you need to learn. The empirical era, the antiseptic era, the aseptic era, and the present experimental era or the biologic era. So you need to learn the names of these eras with the years. This is given in your keynotes. Okay? Okay, another a lot of history again mugging up. The earliest account of pulse therapy was in... What happened, Shinba? It's not there in the keynotes? This is not there in the keynote. Are you people sure? Yeah, history is there. See, there are two histories given at different times. We have just rearranged your keynotes. Yeah, it's there in the start. Got it? Okay. This history is not important for MCQ, okay? You can write there, it's not important. It is not that important. I will tell you which history is important MCQ point of view. Okay, this is not important. The earliest account of pulse therapy, this history comes later in your keynote. The earliest account of pulse therapy was in 1756 when Philip Pfaff packed a small piece of gold over an exposed vital pulse to promote healing. Rebelled exposed pulse is a doomed organ. Rebel said that once your pulse is exposed, you cannot do anything. You need to extract it. Hermann's introduction of calcium hydroxide in 1920 and vital pulpotomy was introduced by Fischer and Zander in 1938. So the MCQ is important over here is Hermann. You already know about the calcium hydroxide and who introduced the vital pulpotomy technique. Okay? These two are important MCQ point of view. Just mark it. Now we come to pulse capping. Okay? Now there are two types of pulse capping, IPC and DPC. Now what are the indications of IPC? Okay, you need to make another sticky over here and stick it near the pulse therapy. Okay, make your sticky four. Indications are used when pulpal inflammation has been judged to be minimal and complete removal of caries would not cause a pulpal exposure. It won't cause a pulpal exposure, okay? So you can say the indications is deep caries but without a pulpal exposure is IPC. Contraindication, when you see any periapical pathology or your pulse vitality tests are positive and all, you cannot go for an IPC. Obviously, you need to go for a root canal or a pulpectomy treatment. So these all are easy, okay? People know all this. So even if you don't want to copy it down, it's okay. The materials used for IPC is calcium hydroxide as we do not remove a part of caries in IPC and keep it because it is actually otherwise we can remove and cause a pulpal exposure, but then we need to go for a DPC. In IPC, we leave a certain amount of hard caries so that it remineralizes and forms secondary dentine or reparative dentine. Okay? Yeah, Radhika, you're right. I'm sorry on that. Okay? And whenever there is a periapical pathology or any radiographic features seen, it is contraindicated. You need to go for a pulpectomy or a root canal treatment. The materials used are calcium hydroxide and zinc oxide eugenol. Both can be used for the IPC treatment. All of you are clear with the indications and contraindications and the materials? Okay, this is just a pictorial view of your IPC. How the caries are removed followed by IPC with a setting calcium hydroxide cement. and then you do a permanent amalgam restoration. And after you do this, within 21 days, you will be able to see a secondary dentine formation present. Earlier, the caries, which was very close to the pulp, has now formed secondary dentine formation, which is either reparative dentine or regenerative dentine. Okay? Now, IPC you can either do in 2 appointments or you can do in 1 appointment. 1 appointment is you remove your caries. On the last patch of caries, you place calcium hydroxide, do a permanent restoration and send off the patient. In 2 appointment conditions, what you do, you remove the caries, you apply calcium hydroxide and you give a temporary restoration in the first appointment. In the second appointment, you can remove the temporary restoration, excavate the calcium hydroxide to see whether your reparative dentine is formed. Again remove the caries if you want to, a little bit more. Put calcium hydroxide and place a permanent restoration in your second appointment. But you know, most of the dentists don't do the second appointment business because it is usually tricky. You may end up doing a pulpal exposure in your second appointment. So most of the people follow the first appointment consideration. Okay? Now all of you know the differences between the infected dentine and the affected dentine. Okay? This is something we have been learning from BDS point of view. So you just need to learn all the differences between the infected dentine and the affected dentine. Okay? Now, which dentine has the ability to remineralize, the infected or the affected dentine? Affected dentine, right. So, when you're doing an IPC, which dentine is left behind? Affected dentine is left behind or infected dentine is left behind? Yeah, affected dentine is left behind. You cannot leave back infected dentine in an IPC tooth. Okay, otherwise there will be again a problem with the tooth. The patient will come back to you with pain and swelling. So just learn this difference because it is very important MCQ point of view. Okay, I already told you an IPC can be one visit or two visits. If two visits, the treated tooth is re-entered in 6 to 8 weeks. Now, the rate of deposition of your reparative dentine has shown to be 1.4 microm per day. Okay, that is your rate of dentine deposition. This is important MCQ point of view. Just make an addition in your IPC sticky of your dentine deposition is at the rate of 1.4 microm per day. The rate of reparative dentine formation is fastest during the first month. And then it decreases after 48 days. So you usually call the patient within 21 days to 30 days to see the reparative dentine formation. And after that, slowly the reparative dentine formation gradually decreases after 48 days. Again, an important MCQ. So make a note of it in your sticky. Now, in successful treatment, color changes from deep red to light gray or light brown, and texture changes from spongy and wet to hard, and caries appear dehydrated. Okay, this is when you re-enter. You are actually re-entering into your, when you are doing a second appointment, okay, you are sure that when the patient is coming back to you the next time, you are again going to remove the temporary restoration and your calcium hydroxide and again try to remove some of the caries. That time, these are the color changes you need to visualize. When you are doing a first appointment case, at that time you cannot leave any spongy wet dentine. You need to go till your hard dentine, then only pack it up with calcium hydroxide. But if you are doing a 2 appointment business, you are doing a 2 appointment case, that time you can leave some amount of infected dentine, recall the patient, remove that infected dentine also, and then as soon as this color is changed, you can easily do a permanent restoration. Clear all of you? So just make the note of the color changes of your dentine in your second appointment case. You made an addition in your sticky, all of you? Yes, reparative dentine formation rate is 1.4 micro-mm per day. Okay, this micro is not visible. Okay. Next we come to DPC. Okay, you all are very well sure of doing you know what is the indication of BPAC. While you're doing removal of the caries, there may be a small mechanical exposure that is surrounded with small dentin, okay, pinpoint. There is a pinpoint pulpal exposure seen, which you need to remove. Only if there is a pinpoint pulpal exposure and that too it is surrounded by good sound dentin, it is a case which is an indication of BPC. Swati, done? Yeah, aseptic condition. Okay. The exposed pulp should have slight red hemorrhage, okay. Whatever your pinpoint pulpal exposure is, it should have a slight red colored hemorrhage, and that could be easily controlled with a cotton pellet. It should not be uncontrollable bleeding from that point. Only if it is controllable, it's a pinpoint pulpal exposure, aseptic condition, sound dentine, it's a good tooth for DPC, the permanent tooth. But pulp capping of a caries pulpal exposure in primary tooth is not recommended. Can anybody tell me why caries DPC is contraindicated in a primary tooth? Yes, good, Saurabh. The calcium hydroxide actually leads to formation of osteoclasts and odontoclasts, which cause internal resorption. Okay? So, make a new sticky 5 and put all the DPC facts in it, your indications. Your contraindications are again same. Your severe toothache, spontaneous pain, periapical pathology, excessive of hemorrhage at the time of exposure, swelling, pus, fistula. All these are indications of higher treatments like pulpectomy, root canal treatment, etc. Okay? Now the materials used for IPC is calcium hydroxide, isobutyl cyanoacrylate, resin bonding agents and corticosteroids. Okay? Other than calcium hydroxide, other agents can also be used like isobutyl cyanoacrylate, resin bonding agents and corticosteroids.